population. Whereas autism spectrum disorder, ASD, is a neurological and developmental disorder affecting the social, communication, and behavioral skills of those affected by it. And whereas, as more health professionals become proficient in diagnosing autism, more children are being diagnosed on the autism spectrum, resulting in rates as high as 1 in 59 children in the United States today. And whereas, individuals with autism often require a lifetime of specialized in community support services to ensure their health and safety, and to support families' resilience as they manage the psychological and financial burdens autism presents. And whereas, while there is no cure for autism, it is well documented that if individuals with autism receive treatment early in their lives, it is often possible for those individuals to lead significantly improved lives, and in some cases live entirely independent. And whereas, Autism North Carolina joins in recognizing and raising awareness efforts in order to educate parents, professionals, and the general public about autism and its effects. Now, therefore, be it resolved that I, Mayor Tate Bailey, do hereby proclaim April 2023 as National Autism Awareness Month for the town of Carlton, and urge all residents to better understand the subject of autism spectrum disorder.
Hold it right there, let me get one.
Thank you.
Excellent Community Volunteers to be recognized April 28, 2023 as National Barber Day in the town of Tarver. I urge all citizens to support efforts to protect our trees and woodlands and to plant trees to gladden the heart for living and well-being of this and of other generations. And lastly, we have a National Day of Prayer proclamation. Whereas the observance of the National Day of Prayer will be held on Thursday, May 4th, 2023, with the theme of Pray Fervently in Righteousness and Availment. And whereas the National Day of Prayer has been part of our country's heritage since it was declared by the first Continental Congress in 1775. And the United States Constitution in 1952 approved a joint resolution setting aside a day each year to pray for our nation. And whereas the United States Congress, by Public Law 100-307, has amended, affirms that it is essential for us as a nation to pray, and whereas the President of the United States set aside and proclaimed the first Thursday of May annually as the National Day of Prayer. And whereas leaders and citizens of our nation are afforded the privilege of prayer with the joy of seeking divine guidance, strength, protection, and comfort from the Lord God. And whereas recognizing the love of God, we, the citizens of Florida, North Carolina, treasure the freedom we have to gather in prayer, exercising our reliance on God's power in the face of the present challenges and threats to the present. And whereas we unite with fellow citizens to ask God for his blessing on every individual of our county. Now, therefore, I, Tate Manning, Mayor of the town of Tarver, do hereby proclaim May 4th, 2023 as a day of prayer throughout the town of Tarver, and I commend this auspice to all of our citizens. Now we move on to requests and petitions of citizens. Be it noted, we do have the Coast Golf Park Ordinance public hearing that will come after the requests and petitions. If you'd like to speak, please do state your name and your address when you can take the petition.
Thank you. The first thing you see is a gas station, the next thing you see is a hotel, and then there's 4.3 acres of land. I should be able to fit two restaurants on that piece of land, sure as well. I'll give you my property. If you will.
Okay, thank you.
That's a professionally written letter too.
Okay.
Took me a long time to apply that. And I'll get that thing checked, and where I got it right. Troy, can I get a letter from you if you need me to add yours, I'll get it. I'll be sure and send it back. Yeah, and that's all I want to give you, what you found, it's under the focus. Bigger business.
What is the problem?
When you get off the Walmart exit, and you see the Exxon gas station there, you turn, and there's the hotel, and then I'm on the 4.3 acres of land. Right, you know where it is, that it's cleared on the US 64 side, and there's a... Well, I'm across from Bojangles, but, you know, it's worse than everything. There's too much traffic.
On the way back, Mr. B, or on the street, right?
Yes, sir. And I, you know, I highly respect both Tina and Catherine. But I just feel like sometimes that little letter, that little bump might help me get over the month, and I seem to be, yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
And I'm a typewriter. I'm selling myself. I don't pay money. I got taxes paid. I'm like everybody else. I got friends. I know the one person I did talk to, his comment was it was gold mine. So, I want some gold. Give me some gold.
Thank you.
All right, thank you. I appreciate your time.
Schedule for public hearing. Tonight we have a proposed off-park ordinance operation or operation ordinance. This public hearing will be held to receive input to consider establishing an ordinance within the town of Harlow to allow golf carts on certain streets within the city limits and the inclusion of any additional restrictions that would make the ordinance as safe as possible. Notice that this public hearing has appeared in the local newspaper. I declare this public hearing open. I would like to call on the town manager to give us some background information on the proposed golf cart operation ordinance.
Background would be brief. Essentially, a couple of different times now, we've had citizens approach various council members about the desire to allow golf carts within the city of Sephora. Staff has researched it and provided council with a model ordinance based on what DOT provided as a model ordinance, and that's where we're at. Once again, we had a public hearing on this about a year ago. So this is the second time it's come out. We had several citizens request this. It's before you leave the council to take whatever action they deem necessary.
Is there anyone who wishes to speak in favor of the proposed golf cart operation of ordinance?
Hello, Council. We have seen it before. I'm glad. And I would like to propose the...
Please say
your name. Oh, my name and address. My name is Alicia Burbo. I'm a citizen list to get to difficult locations or just ride around in the neighborhood without breaking the law. And I think it would be good that if people around the town can get to the river without using a vehicle, burning gas, we can just ride down to the river for fishing and activities with the family side. That's the idea, but I think it would be great for the people to get around.
Good evening. My name is Richard Redwood. I live at 501 Wayne Avenue, and I'm here to request that the town give proper consideration to the fact that whether the golf cart in town, depending on what provides the statistics, is advantageous. It's economical. Yes, we're not going to suck again, but with that being said, town very and thoroughly consider passing the ordinance that it is safe for them. Town members as well as whoever operates a golf cart. So now I'm saying this been proposed for the second time. But hopefully maybe it gets from Stephen to something. That's about all I have. I appreciate you coming.
Allow the young people to get out and feel safe and get back home.
traffic in the 45 zones. That's why the state said the limits would be 35 miles per hour. That way, 20 miles per hour would be safe. But you're just 15 below the limit, where if you're on 45 or 55, there's a big discrepancy. It's like having minimum speeds on the interstate. So make sure you travel at a certain speed so you're not impeding traffic.
And I'd like to say one thing if I could. I think it'll definitely help the town as people come in late in the evening and see the elderly people on the streets. Because really, it's about 6 o'clock when you're rolling the sidewalks. And I think this will really help. That might not be able to see some good news, and that's okay. But we want our town to feel safe. We feel safe. Thank you, Mr.
Me?
Yes.
Sheriff.
Okay, I know you deal with a lot of sports people. Electric and gas, both of those we all do as far as speed. The government over speed.
They can be, but within certain occupations, normally it's about the power. A 72 volt is paired to a 48 volt, which is standard, and then the older parts are 36 volt.
Gas could be more altered, but I do think when you come into the LSB law, if you're staying within that law, it sets a parameter that I don't believe a gas LSB vehicle qualifies under the North Carolina statute. I don't think you're going to see that, but you know that's the biggest improvement right now is in electric vehicles. So you're going to see modifications that we don't know about that are going to come up.
My thing is this actually, I think, of this
electric
and golf carts are all able to be lost through the state.
And that's probably a
thing to tell you about.
Just a comment to my question. DOT's recommended model ordinance, the most ones I've seen, you cap the speed of 20 miles an hour. So if you had a park or a road that technically wouldn't meet the requirements of the ordinance, we would eventually have that park in excess of 20 miles an hour. And if you would call one faster than 20 miles an hour, anyone else that wishes to speak in favor of the proposed call for an operation?
Hey everyone, I'm back. Liam Gilroy, right on the number there, 204 East Park. Candidly, I'm not on either side of this. I'm looking at through the lens of what we're trying to do in town. So, the comment about pedestrian traffic, does it get more people downtown? Does it help our merchants? Does it help our restaurants? Does it make people feel safer? All good arguments. I've been thinking about this all day. I've talked with the mayor this morning, you know, because I don't know how I feel about it. I would just encourage y'all, just like, you know, we had a big lively discourse about the social district. I saw some people like thinking about it. Like, I try to look at everything we're doing each other with the lens of, is this enhancing? And y'all have a definition of that. Like, is it inclusive? Are we bringing it together? Are we really helping Tarver? So, you know, again, I'm really not on either side here. I'm kind of looking to be swayed either way, but I encourage everyone as we gather feedback forum here to think about that, because again, I'm not going to buy a but I'm feeling pretty good. I walk downtown. My mom, though, is in mobile, so, you know, she moves closer to us, you know, downtown, you know, she might be a candidate to get to church and her stuff. So I had thought of that. I appreciate that perspective. So that's all I'd like to encourage, just like be open-minded, think about it. But candidly, I'm on the fence. I'm going to see which way I fall away from the building tonight. But appreciate your time.
Is there anyone else?
there's a couple things that's misconceptions about all cultures occurring for. You talk about LSD. There are all parks out there now that can be LSD and licensed. We're going to permit them here, but the policy is stable. The difference in that kind of golf park is about $10,000. I've actually got one. We put license tag on the ground and go to town. We cannot see some of the people when I found $10,000-$15,000 golf park. What most of the towns are doing is allowing the older golf parks that do not have a speed, the small ones to be licensed, and they're becoming an active part of the community. And I think that's the biggest part. Think about now with the library that we sit here, if you're looking at mobility and you're looking at people getting around, the golf cart needs to just slide in and sit in without having to climb up. It gives a lot of people that do not have the ability a chance to move around, sit naked, and be involved in the community. So one thing that's already happened that most of you may or may not know is you already have side by side vehicles that are strictly. And the big utility vehicles, so they're gas pumps. So that application is already there. And again, it's already in the books, just like the LSD is already in the books.
What's the LSD?
Low speed vehicles. If you follow within those guidelines, which we do modify some units in our business for primarily gas, they'll run 67 miles an hour, following the same guidelines as before. So I think what you're really talking about in the dog park type of just around the vehicles is being a part of the community, being a part of what we're trying to do with the town park. We want to open mind. It's common. It's pretty obvious it's coming. It's just puts a little bit ahead, and I think it's a very attractive program for where the town is moving forward. And particularly, as the gentleman mentioned about the elders, and I'm fast becoming part of that, where you can just move in. I don't know about the truck, I don't know about all the other, it would be nice sometimes to just have something to go around the neighborhood, go around the community, go around the grocery store. Mainly wanted to emphasize, don't be confused about too much comparison of an LSD, too much comparison of a street legal side by side. All that's completely different than you got the towns. You got Boulder, that's golf park approved. You got Charleston, and that size of town that is golf park approved. Now, here, I'm golf park approved. And it goes on and on. So it's definitely a trend. What's happening. So it's kind of, I would think that would be a good plus to have to go forward.
Can I ask Mr. Chair a question?
Yes, sir.
What is your business? Why does the North Carolina DOT not allow putting a license plate on a gasoline operated golf cart when it is on an electric golf cart? Why do they not tag a gas powered golf cart?
That's a very good question. I think that the problem is gas power, those are idle, they're permitted to limit the control of them. And if you look at the specific law now for gas powered vehicles that are utility vehicles, not home vehicles, you have to have a certain size, a certain height, a certain width. You have to have windshields, it's a whole stretch of ordinances that go into making it legal. It's not coming in factory like that. And by passing the law that came into effect about a year ago, maybe a little over a year, it has to run, the person I mentioned about minimum speed, it has to run a certain limit. It has to be able to run the traffic. It cannot be used on primary roads, it can only be used on secondary roads. The gas golf carts, all this is kind of a no-man's land. I mean, really, when it comes to that. So most people that want the electric do it because they want to be quiet. They want to be subdued. They do not want to have a neighborhood have a lot of noise
the safety of the golf course on the road. Our traffic issues here aren't so bad, but once we have an influx of golf course on there, I'm concerned with what that does to the environment that are on Main Street or off on the side roads if they don't know that they're going to be there. So I think if we approve this, there needs to be some type of notification somehow, some way to let the drivers inform those golf carts are on the road. Are in those areas in both or in the back where golf carts are allowed. And it took a while before the town were to incorporate those because traffic wasn't used to it. So if that guy is going down Main Street, all of a sudden 6 o'clock, you have 2 or 3 golf carts down the road. You're hard, you're not hard to miss if you're not looking for them. So I would say, let's have a trial period. If you approve it, great. Let's have a trial, see how it works if you're not in there. And then the past year, just get a forward from there. But I'm a little concerned about the safety of the golf carts and the safety of the golf carts on the road without some type of official notification that all the vehicle type of things. That's all I'm
saying. Thank you, sir.
So,
my name is Brian Meadows, but at 601 St. Andrew Street. I'm over there. I do have a local Airbnb. It's interesting to me. I talk to a lot of folks who come in. A lot of them come to see the historic houses. A lot of them come to see the gardens, like a town. And I think it would be nice for some of these people, you know, if it was a place, if they could ride a golf cart, it would be centuries. And not really, you know. Somebody gets out there on 64, that's just asking for funds. And maybe some of the streets around the corner are maybe asking for funds. But I do think they can be incorporated, like Lewis said, you know, maybe you have a lot of signage up ahead of time before you ever incorporate. Maybe put a light strobe or something, yellow strobe or something about the golf cart, make that required. So it does. But I do think it would be, that's not useful. Thank you, sir.
Anybody else wish to speak in favor? Is there anyone who wishes to speak against the proposed golf cart operation? Hearing none, I declare this public hearing closed. It would be appropriate at this time for a member of the council to make a motion for or against the approval of the proposed golf cart ordinance. Motion for approval. Do I hear a second?
Second.
Got a motion and a second. Further discussion?
Yes. I'd like to clarify
on certain things, of course, what a golf cart is, which is a vehicle design manufactured by a person, a golf course for sporting purposes and purposes that is not capable of exceeding a $20 per hour, for instance. The outlines and rules and regulations, including this, are keeping it operating only or alongside a public road or street with a posted speed limit greater than 35 miles an hour. It talks about how they have to cross streets and they will be required to cross streets that are in excess of 35 miles an hour, they have to do something correct. And that being 16 operating hour required. They have to be registered with the town, including paying the registration fee of, I believe, we said it at $150 after the discussion last time. Things like that. The police department is responsible for inspecting the car that is first mentioned to make sure that it's
correct. Okay, just turning to
Yes, sir. This would allow electric and gas. Yes, both.
And so you already have some description.
Yes, sir. This is ordinance attached.
Yeah. I see the proposal.
Yes, of course. Yeah.
I see that. I just want to please don't ask me questions. We need to vote on this ordinance.
That would be appropriate. That would be a recommendation to vote on an ordinance. Could be this ordinance or with any modification that you want to propose. This ordinance is written. DOT put out a model ordinance with recommended language for towns to use. Primarily, most of the that I looked at in other towns were some form of this, very similar to this. Different councils may charge a different registration or make some minor changes to it, but this is the model language provided by NC DOT.
And the question is, that you do have
I don't have a problem with it at all. I think, much like some work we've attempted in recent years that have turned out successful, don't have a problem with it in the shop. Seeing how it goes. This council decides to withdraw it some other day. But in talking to other town managers that have implemented these, we're typically pleased with the results.
Councilor Brown clarified his motion was it to approve the proposed ordinance that
yes.
Okay. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
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 Yes. Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Our park is basically 9 by 19, I think, so I've been receiving a walk in the space.
I got a few things I'd like to
talk about. Let me see if you have any questions.
Couple things I'd like to highlight in the ordinance is that the financial responsibility that these vehicles have liability insurance coverage. Anyone operating
like I said, I passed out something that the union was Town of Vincent's golf cart ordinance. I know we were looking at our model ordinance. I would just like to ask for at least one change in our model ordinance. It's saying 25 miles per hour. I would like to see 35. I would like to propose that be amended to 35 miles per hour because if you limit it to 25, you're going to be kind of skirting just the residential areas of town. People that might want to get to certain restaurants or say a food line or somewhere like that, 25 is going to restrict them from getting there. Also, $150 for the fee. I didn't know what y'all proposed over a year ago. 150 is kind of steep because if you look at registering the vehicle, you're almost paying for an actual registration town of Benson, if you look at that, their says $40 is actually $60 a m. A lot of ones I looked at, they were Washington and Farmville were two of our neighbors. And we like to model a lot of our stuff after Washington, and we actually have a golf cart ordinance. Theirs is less than $100. That would help out as far as cost. $150 annual is a big cost if you're talking about having fees plus charges somebody $150 for a golf cart. We're looking at safety. I know we're saying like a strobe, they still have to have headlights and taillights, and they'll have those on them. Particularly every golf cart will have that. If not, there is also a golf having a reflector on the back, a big triangle reflector, which is what your wheelchairs have to have on when they go down the road. That's it. One of the things been said, and one of the things Benson mentioned, Benson has what's called mule days in Benson. Benson's half of our population, but the mule days happens over a 3-day period. They have over 30,000 people comes to town in Benson. They have hundreds, if not over 1,000 golf carts. People actually roll the line and get the police department to go ahead and pre-register their golf carts so they can contain them. They can be looked at by the police department, they get their sticker, and during that 3 days, they get the ride. So if we have a festival, that would be something we could use at a festival. They even dedicate a lane, like we mark off Main Street for a festival. We actually dedicate a lane to golf carts so people who are have mobility limitations can get down to the festival and arrange parking for them. So that's just some of the benefits. You know, like I said, I'd like to see it 35, I'd like to see it lowered as far as the fee. I leave that, I didn't bother being a proponent of this, but I just leave it that. And I find that just being electric, I'm good with just electric. So if you want to do that, I'm good with it.
That's the next thing. Ordinance that's in front of us is 35 miles an hour.
Well, my agenda, I got this is 25. On my electronic agenda, this is 25.
Yes, sir.
The DOT model says 35. DOT does. The DOT model says 35. Yes, all right. Well, DOT is golf course. It doesn't need to lay gas or less. It's just golf course. It's just 35 miles. I'm doing this for that.
Well, I appreciate Mr. Brax's comment on that. My concern last year, still this year, is that you talk about including gas powered golf course that cannot be tagged by the DOT. We've got electric golf carts. I know there was a gentleman here last year that actually parked his outside. Had all the safety equipment on it. Electric golf cart had a North Carolina DOT tag on it. And that's what my feeling is. You've got a vehicle that can run up and down the street. To me, it should have a North Carolina tag on it. Gas fibers cannot. For whatever reason, nobody's ever been able to ask me specifically why they won't allow a gas operated golf cart. But that's my concern. Again, if we're going to have vehicles on the street, I just believe they should have a North Carolina motor vehicle tag on it, as my truck does, and your car, or anybody else. But, that's, and again, I still haven't heard anybody bring forth that they've got a gas operated golf cart. Right now, today, all we got to do is go put a tag on it for safety equipment that this ordinance would call for, and they can drive anywhere in Georgia. So that's my question, is why do we need an ordinance as such when you can get on an electric golf cart with a tag and a safety equipment that the ordinance is going to require?
I can actually answer that for you. With any golf cart, golf carts are required to be inspected at licensed golf cart. And you should check, correct me if I'm wrong, licensed golf cart inspection stations. And every inspection station is not a licensed golf cart inspection station, if I'm correct. And I'm 99% sure I'm correct. You have to go to a golf cart inspection station to get it inspected. And if you go to one of those stations, you can actually register a gas-powered golf cart if it is inspected by a golf cart inspection station that's certified. You can put it on the, best thing, you put a regular registration plate and follow all the regular rules of the road, but you can register gas. I'm just saying let's stick with the electric and make it by this ordinance. It makes it more convenient, especially for elderly people. It's already tough to go through a registration process. And so that's another reason I'm asking for this. We're saying we're a retirement community, we're friends to the elderly. Hey, let's make it friendly to the elderly and let's have people be able to ride.
If the gas is not only uses the food in the business, then it's the doctor of the food gas is only in the business. So that's not already to everything. The legs of the things have, they do try to use it. If they can attain it, the only one who showed this whole mix is the one who put it up for a while. Now, gasoline operators.
As I said, it's the convenient for people. It's the convenience for people. It makes it more convenient for people to be able to drive the golf carts. That's the main thing. Yeah, I mean, you can go get a tag, but then you're going to have to every year, just like if you did for your car, you're going to have to go over and get your sticker. You're going to have to get inspected, you got to get your sticker, you're going to pay property taxes every year on that. Whereas these fees here, if you think about it, we can get property taxes in town when we do that, but this fee that you're proposing is more than what the property tax would be on a typical golf cart, so it's actually money in the town's pocket instead of going to the state. It actually benefits us.
Yes, sir.
I'm prepared to vote for the office.
Four reasons.
Over CB. Right up.
23-15 is related to the report of unpaid taxes, liens, and real props and tax lien advertising. General Statute 105-369 requires that the tax collector report to council the total amount of unpaid taxes for the current fiscal year and liens on real property, the total amount of unpaid taxes for 2022, and liens on real property is $195,505.92. Unpaid taxes on property tax credit. General Statute 105-369 also requires that the governing body order the tax credit to advertise these tax liens. Advertisement must be made at least one time between March 1st and June 30th. Effective July 1, 2006, after the governing body orders the tax credit to advertise the tax lien, the collector must send a notice to the owner of record must be sent to the date before it is recommended. The date advertised is to be published. It's recommended that Council 1 approve the report of the tax collector on unpaid 2022 taxes that are linked on real property, and 2 order the tax collector to advertise the taxes that are linked on real property one time as soon as all statutory requirements are met.
So approved.
Motion and second. Further discussion? All those in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Memo 23-16 is related to a budget amendment for HVAC unit at Horizon Recreation Center on November 18, 2022. The center experienced a strong gas over inside the building. The HVAC unit had just been serviced and repaired. The strong odor was a concern, and therefore reported. Representatives from Piedmont Gas responded to the call and found investigation to take very high readings. The facility's 2 HVAC units were shut down and the units were locked down and tagged out for safety purposes. On Monday the 21st, it was determined that the facility's main unit was in need of replacement as the heat exchanger had crashed by the gas that stayed in both sanctuaries. The failure requires replacement as soon as possible to minimize impacts on the facility's operations and to provide adequate heat to protect the facility from radiation damages. Therefore, we have to do an emergency replacement of that unit, especially the castle for the attached budget replacement.
Second.
Motion and second. So, we are budgeting from the fund balance from the general fund to cover the house. Motion and second. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. All right. Memo 23-17 is related to another budget amendment. This one regards to the rural transformation grant. As council is aware, the town was awarded $875,000 in rural transformation grant funds to the rural economic development division of the Department of Commerce. The funds will be utilized to enhance the connection between downtown Riverfront Park and rural stabilizing the Miami Tar River at Riverfront Park. It's recommended the council adopt a resolution for the $875,000 in rural transportation grant funds so that we can expand those funds.
So moved.
And the second. Further discussion?
Just as soon as we receive this work, we can
have RF. For internet services is out now, as soon as we award that contract, that will begin the process.
So, that's just for the Riverfront Divisions?
Yes, the other part of the number of Divisions and Magic, which the Division is inside of all that's going on to the
Riverfront Divisions.
That's right.
Are you going to be in the Wayfinders? I've asked before about the markers for the things and stuff, historically, that are no longer black businesses, downtown markers, historic markers.
Not as a part of this grant.
Okay. there's no reason for that.
Well, I mean, it's certainly something to look at. We're currently under our downtown planning process, you know, for most of our basic next year. I'd also, could also work with our,
second, any discussion?
those in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Motion carries.
I make a motion to approve the performance indicator chart with acknowledge that you see.
Second. Motion to second. Further discussion?
All those in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries.
As I mentioned, I'm going to pass that there was a letter that Captain Smith that each council member had signed for this. I'll just pass it around as he was signed as a guy.
Memo 28-23-19 is resolution fix of a fixed asset. The town of Tallboro currently has a 1986 Ford EDI fire engine, which is provided for our needs. It's one of the jobs for the need for such equipment as traffic school and public safety training courses. And that equipment is beyond its use for the town and a very limited value for resale. Staff feels that the town will derive greater benefit from its use of training tool at Edgemont Community College than it would be from competitive sales. North Carolina Statute 168-274 authorized the government unit in this state to exchange it at least two whose from, sale to, or purchase from any other government unit with an interest in real or personal property. Upon such terms and conditions as the government deems with or without consideration, it is recommended that council approve the attached resolution declaring the 1986 fire engine described in Exhibit A surplus and conveying the same to Edgemont Community College for no consideration.
So moved.
Got a motion and a second. Is there any further discussion? All those in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed?
Memo 23-20 is service traffic changes, traffic schedule changes were recommended in NCDOT and new service sections of Wilson Street or NC-111 in Charleroi that have outdated speed limit ordinances in fact on the books. The bulk of these ordinances is necessary for the town to execute a municipal ordinance certificate to replace the outdated ordinances and amend the time to call the traffic schedule. Those sections, these are all, these sections are all passed. We kind of don't know what's outside the city limits currently. You should go past Simpson Drive and out towards the community college. These are all sections, this map included. These are sections that were probably in effect before that was part of the town limit years ago. And so they're just updating those. No change in the speed limit of what's there now, but they do need to adopt these kind of ordinance. And in research, we found that they were also not included in our transition. So, the three sections again are NC-111, which is Dorset Street from 24.41 miles west of Ball Road, eastward to distance for Alton, into between 0.01 miles northeast of Pinera Road and 0.44 miles northeast of Pinera Road. Also between 0.44 miles northeast of Pinera Road and 0.824 miles north of Pinera Road. And again, that's the stretch of this that we have, but it's just for the involvement. In addition to those changes requested by NCDOT, the town of Tallboro needs to amend the town of Tallboro traffic schedule to add stop signs for Cambridge Commons Phase 2 at the following locations. This is Phase 2, this is the new development. So adjacent to existing Cambridge Commons Phase 1, Ashley Court and Westchester Drive, Somerset Court and Ashley Court and Industrial Parkway. It is recommended that council execute the attached municipal ordinance certificates to correct the speed limit and accuracies as requested by DOT and adopt the attached resolution amended to track the schedule described.
So moved.
Second.
Got a motion and a second. Is there any further discussion? All those in favor, signify by saying
aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. All right, number 23-21 is the way to the town of Rockland. Based on an application from town staff, has been selected by the International City County Manager.
participate in the learning and training cohort funded through the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation's Economic Mobility and Opportunity Program. Embedded within the ICBA's local government community management initiative, efforts to educate local leaders about drivers and mobility and opportunity and what is working in terms of moving the needle for the security, health, and welfare of vulnerable residents and communities across the country. Only 10 communities were selected across the nation to participate in the program. Tarbell was selected based on our ability and readiness to implement a strategy to improve the lives of our citizens. The full list is included here. It includes the one from Wisconsin, Chesterfield County, Virginia, Iowa, El Paso County, Texas, Grand Island, Nebraska, Russian, Oregon, Meadville, Pennsylvania, Morgan Hill, California, San Juan County, Utah, and Tarbell, North Carolina. As a participant in the cohort, the mayor, myself, and the planning director, we're participating in a series of cooperative training and discussion sessions with other communities. All travel-related expenses for participation will be paid for through the program. As a participant of the program, Tarboro will also receive $30,000 to conduct the study of housing needs within the community. It's recommended that Tarboro Town Council agree for Tarboro to participate in the program and authorize the town manager to execute documents for the
consent.
That motion is second. Any further discussion?
I'd just like to say, I went and looked, and this is really good. I went and looked on the site for this when it came up, and some of the things it mentions, and you think about it, does apply, especially to Edgecombe County and Tarver. They focus on anybody living at 200% below poverty level. Poverty level, 200% below poverty level is $27,180 a year. There's a lot of people in town talking about less than $27,180 a year. Also, if you go to this site, I think some all of us as council members should do, if you go to this site, you can actually sign up, and they will send you updates as far as what's going on with this and what opportunities are out there, and you can get regular emails from this organization. So they're really doing a good job at trying to bring economic vitality to communities.
Any further discussion? Yeah. Motion is second. All those in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Okay, we move up 23-22 related to a special event. Specifically, the Tarboro Edgecombe Public Arts Commission is working on co-sponsoring the inaugural Tarboro Edgecombe Juneteenth celebration in conjunction with Freedom Forum of Edgecombe County. The event is proposed to be held in downtown Tarboro on Monday, June 19th, 2023, from 10 to 8 p.m. We feature live entertainment, a variety of genres, keynote speakers, art activities for children, food trucks, and other vendors. The main stage and children's art camp will be located on Courthouse Square. The Tarboro Edgecombe Public Arts Commission is requesting in-kind support from the town of the stage, for the floors, trash cans, and other items of that nature. In order to receive approval from NCDOT to close Main Street for the celebration, it is necessary to adopt an ordinance declaring the road closure. It is recommended the council agree to co-sponsor the event and adopt the attached ordinance declaring the closure of North Main Street between Pitt Street and St. John Street.
So moved.
Second.
Motion and second. Further discussion? Any further discussion? All those in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. NO 23-22 is also related to a special event. This is related to Hispanic Heritage Festival. In 1988, President Obama was an advocate of Hispanic Heritage Month to run the second. Hispanic Heritage Month recognizes the contributions of Hispanic Americans by made to the United States. September 15th was chosen as the starting point because many Latin American countries celebrate their Independence Day on the day that day. Lucinda Vicencio is looking to create a new special event for the town to celebrate the depth and diversity of the culture of the Hispanic community with art, food, Power and Community, and it will take place on September 16, 2023, from 1 to 6 p.m. on the town common. Since the request of in-kind support from the town to stage, portable doors, trash cans, dance floor, hand seat, tables, etc., much like a beautiful cabin. It is recommended that council agree to co-sponsor the first Hispanic Heritage Festival scheduled for September 16th from 1 to 6 on the Charlestown Common by providing in-kind services and
equipment.
Second.
Got a motion and a second. Is there any further discussion?
Motion carries.
Okay, number 23-24 is related to our minimum housing code enforcement. At September 12, 2022 meeting, Council adopted an ordinance for homeless, 614 Market Kingsbury Drive, to provide the inspector's order to repair the demolished structure within 60 days. The ordinance authorized the inspector to remove the demolished building that owners did not supply. The unit has been demolished by the building inspector at a cost of $18,851.52. In order for this cost to be assessed as a lien against the property, it will be necessary for council to hold a public hearing and adopt a resolution confirming the assessment, role, and levying assessment. It is recommended that council call for a public hearing on the assessment for demolition cost of $18,851.52. And the structure located at 614 Martin Luther King Jr. Drive at the May 8th, 2023. Motion to approve.
Second.
Got a motion and a second. Further discussion? All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. All right. Similarly, 23-25 related to minimum housing code enforcement. This at 208 Shirley Street. At the August 8th, 2022 meeting, council adopted an ordinance directing owners of the above referenced property to comply with the building inspector's order to repair the demolished structure within 60 days. The ordinance authorized the inspector to remove the demolished dwelling if the owner did not comply. The unit has been demolished by the inspector at a cost of $13,066.45. In order for this cost to be assessed as a lien against the property, it is necessary for council to hold a public hearing and adopt a resolution confirming the assessment role. It is recommended that council call for the hold a public hearing in May 2022 meeting to assess the demolition cost of $13,066.45.
So moved.
Got a motion?
Second.
A second. Further discussion?
Question. For both of the properties, were they ever property?
We have had a deal with the legislature. We discuss right now that address of issues with ill property.
I don't know if it's there were new title sections for new issues and start the process and go to the home for work and do that process. You know that one.
Not what I'll talk here about for sure.
Do we have anything on the book that addresses property or
if it's identified within the title sort of procedure, that's what it represents. Contact identified with some law. That's not a process. Got a motion and a second. It's a little bit of discussion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. That's all the action items I have. Yeah, I just have a couple of things. Wanted to let council know that today is Line Work Appreciation Day. Thank our line workers for the work that they do. Also, this week, yesterday started National Public Safety Telecommunications Week. That runs from April 9th to the 18th. So both of these people play a big role in our community as far as keeping them safe and making things happen. Just want to cancel more about that. I want to remind council that on May the 3rd at Cotton Valley Golf Course, that's there's going to be a luncheon from 11:30 to 12:35. was where we were celebrating our key accounts, individuals, and then kind of giving them an update on the status of the town and finding out ways that our major industries and key customers, what needs they might have from us, and just opening those lines of communication. So the luncheon, as I said, will be from 11:30 to 12:45, and then we'll have a call out.
Development, but the state or housing finance is not an issue.
says that it's the need from the garage.
And I wanted to make it clear, when I say affordable housing, I'm not talking about government subsidized section 8 housing.
Something in there, and then power. Good. soon. Not soon.